hey, fellow scientists. Sorry,
I always get carried away when I'm listening to my favorite band. It just blows my mind how every sound from the singer's voice to the bass guitar to the drums are all created by the vibration of matter. So cool. By the end of today's lesson, you will be able to describe how sound travels as waves and explain how the shape of those waves determines what we hear. Let's get into it. Sound is vibration. Particles moving back and forth are responsible for every sound we hear. So, what makes the beep from my microwave sound different from the beep of my alarm clock? Well, it's how matter vibrates that determines what every sound sounds like. Is the matter vibrating
very quickly?
Or very slowly?
Is the matter going through a huge movement?
Or just wiggling the teensiest bit? By following how each particle of matter moves with sound vibrations, we get what's called a sound wave, or the pattern of vibration caused by sound energy. Let's take a look at what I mean by watching just one particle of matter. It begins at rest. Then, when a force causes it to make a sound, it moves back and forth a certain distance. When we follow that movement over time, we get this. A sound wave. By looking at the shape of a sound wave, we can learn a lot about what a sound sounds like. For instance, the top of the wave is called the peak, just like the top of a mountain. And the bottom of the wave is called the trough, like what farm animals drink from. How far a particle moves from its starting point to either a peak or a trough is called its amplitude. Amplitude shows us the strength of a sound wave, or how much energy was behind the force that created it. The more energy, the farther back and forth the matter will vibrate. On a sound wave, more energy looks like taller peaks and deeper troughs, while less energy looks like shorter peaks and shallower troughs. How do you think the amount of energy put into making a sound changes how we perceive or hear it? Pause the video here and listen for the difference yourself. Clap your hands together, once softly, and once with a lot of force. Record the differences you observe in your guided notes.
The sound of my voice currently has a large amplitude. Sorry, you probably noticed that when you clapped your hands together hard, the sound was a lot louder than when you did it so softly. We perceive the energy of a sound as the sound's loudness or volume. So, the amplitude of a wave tells us how loud or quiet the volume of the sound is. So, which wave is showing a louder sound? Right, the matter is moving farther from its starting point in this wave, showing us that this is the louder sound. Which one is showing a quieter sound? Good, the wave with the smaller amplitude represents a quieter sound. The amplitude of a sound wave shows the volume of a sound. Volume is not the only way we perceive differences in sound, though. Can you think of any other ways sounds can sound differently from each other? Right!
Sometimes a sound can sound low.
And sometimes a sound can sound high!
The highness or lowness of a sound is called its pitch. And that's also something we can see when we look at a sound wave. Have you ever noticed what happens to the sound on a video
when you put it in slow-mo?
Or
when you're trying to watch a video quickly, so you put it on 2x speed?
Ugh, don't let me do that again.
But did you notice how the pitch of my voice got lower when it was slowed down and higher when it was sped up?
That's because the speed of the vibration is what determines a sound's pitch. When matter vibrates faster, it creates a higher pitch. And when it vibrates slower, it creates a lower pitch. Let's take a look at how we can see that on a sound wave. The faster matter vibrates, the more sound waves there are during a given period of time. That measurement is called frequency. We could determine the frequency of a wave by looking at its wavelength, or the distance between two peaks or two troughs. A higher frequency means the wave has a shorter wavelength, which makes the wave look kind of squished together. A higher frequency creates a higher pitch. You can think of frequency like the word frequent. It's describing how frequently or how often something is happening. If a high frequency sound looks like a lot of waves close together with a short wavelength, what do you think a low frequency sound would look like? When a sound has a low frequency, the matter is vibrating slowly. There are fewer waves per second, so there is a greater distance between each peak of the wave, or a longer wavelength. A low frequency sound wave looks stretched out and long. Sounds with a high frequency have a high pitch, and sounds with a low frequency have a low pitch. Pause the video here and label which wave has a high pitch and which has a low pitch in your guided notes. Let's review everything we've learned about sound today. When sound causes matter to vibrate, it creates sound waves. The amplitude of a sound wave is the distance between the starting point of the matter moving and a peak or a trough. A high amplitude means the sound has a high volume, and a low amplitude means the sound has a low volume. The frequency of a wave is the number of waves happening in one period of time. The higher the frequency, the higher the pitch. The lower the frequency, the lower the pitch. To learn more about sound waves, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. Man, I can't wait until I see my favorite band perform in person. I'll be able to think about the shape of each sound wave as I'm watching the show. Maybe I could even snag some kind of backstage pass so I can teach the band all about it too. Or if I wear my ninja outfit, I don't need a backstage pass at all. Just kidding. And remember, scientists, science is all around us. See you next time.